While this might look like a home cleared for sale, look again. It's about to come down all the way to the studs as it's part of a pilot program for Chinese drywall.
We placed this once and I said I gave up.
Every wall in Bill Palsgraf's home is made of Chinese drywall, but in a way, the Port St. Lucie man considers himself lucky.
About 15 to 20% of the outlets in the house don't work anymore.
His class action suit against the German importer settled, and Palsgraf quickly got himself in a pilot program for just 300 homeowners to test out the best way to remediate the problem.
They're going to gut all the walls, the copper piping, all the electrical, the tile, the bathrooms. The only thing they're basically saving are the floors.
Palsgraf had all the telltale signs: high levels of sulfur, corroded copper, failing appliances. The 48-year-old has learned everything he can about the problem.
I kept on top of everything. I followed day by day news articles, newspaper articles, blogs, Facebook.
It's been chaos for Palsgraf and his family since he discovered the drywall back in 2009 when he had a buyer for his home. But this has all had some unintended consequences. Political aspirations.
I saw all the people being hurt. I see the bank stepping on everybody.
If he sounds like a candidate, it's because he plans to be one, gathering signatures for a run for Congress.
I can see congressmen all around the country stepping up to the plate. I don't see any congressmen in the state of Florida stepping up to the plate.
Palsgraf expecting to be out of the home about 5 to 6 months, hoping his Chinese drywall-fueled nightmare is coming to an end. Reporting in Port St. Lucie, I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.